In this screencast, we're going to determine the radius of a lead atom and the density of lead. So the first question we have to ask is, what kind of unit cell is lead? And if we look at this picture on the left, lead is face-centered cubic. In other words, it has atoms on all the corners of its unit cells, as well as atoms on each face. So the lattice constant, A, is equal to 495 picometers, which is 495 times 10 to the minus 12 meters. So this lattice constant, A, goes from here to here. And if you take a look at this picture and look at a diagonal that goes through there, you will notice that it is 4 times the radius of an atom. So we can rewrite this looking at a right triangle. This is 4 times R. And here A and A are our lattice constants. So we can write this using the Pythagorean theory as R equals A squared, which is our lattice constant, divided by 8 and take the square root of that. So this is going to equal the square root of 495 picometers squared divided by 8, or 175 picometers. So that's the radius of a lead atom. Now we have to find the density. And the density, by definition, is the mass divided by the volume. So we're going to look at our unit cell, and the volume of our unit cell is just A, the lattice constant, cubed. To find the mass in our unit cell, we first have to find the mass of one lead atom, and then multiply it by the number of atoms in our unit cell. So how do we find the mass of one atom? That's going to equal the molar mass of lead, 207.2 grams per mole of atoms. And then we divide that by Avogadro's number, 6.022 times 10 to the 23 atoms per mole. And what we're left with is 3.4 times 10 to the minus 22 grams per atom of lead. Now we have to figure out how many atoms there are in our unit cell. So let's go back and take a look at our unit cell. And you can see in each face, there is 1/2 of an atom and there are 6 faces. So we have 1/2 of an atom per face and we have 6 faces. Now let's go back and take a look at the corners. And at each one of these corners, right here, we have 1/8 of an atom and we have 8 corners. So we add to this 1/8 of an atom per corner, and we multiply that by 8 corners. And so what we're left with is 4 atoms in our unit cell. So we multiply 4 atoms of lead by 3.4 times 10 to the minus 22 grams per atom of lead. And that's our mass. And we divide this by our volume, which is A cubed, or 4.95 times 10 to the minus 8 centimeters cubed. And we're going to end up with a density in grams per centimeter cubed of 11.3 grams per centimeter cubed.